الحمد لله، الحمد لله الذي جعل هذه الأمة قوية بإسلامها، عزيزة بإيمانها. قال الله تعالى: ولله العزة ولرسوله وللمؤمنين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى الآل وصحب الكرام. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ألا فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكما ورد في الرواية: وكل ضلالة في النار. ألا فاتقوا الله عباد الله، وتمسكوا من الإسلام بالعروة الوثقى، واحذروا غضب الرب، فإن أجسادكم على النار لا تقوى. O servants of Allah and O children of Adam, we begin in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we request His assistance and guidance, and we seek refuge in Him from the evil of ourselves and the adverse consequences of our deeds. And we testify that whomsoever He guides subhanahu wa ta'ala, then none can misguide, and whomsoever He misguides, then none can guide. And we request praises and blessings upon the final messenger, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I bear witness that there's no one worthy of worship besides one Allah, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His messenger. O servants of Allah, Imam ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he eloquently describes the Sharia in a poetic paragraph in his writings, in which he says, فَإِنَّ الشَّرِيعَةَ مَبْنَاهَا وَأَسَاسَهَا على المصالح أو على مصالح العباد والحكم في المعاش والمعاد. He says that this Sharia, the Sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's built and founded and rooted upon wisdoms and upon transformative benefit that benefits us both in this life and the next. He says, فَإِنَّ الشَّرِيعَةَ Indeed, the Sharia, عدل كلها ورحمة كلها ومصالح كلها وحكم كلها. He says, indeed, the Sharia, everything about it is justice and mercy and transformative benefit and wisdom. And when we ponder over this paragraph, my dearest brothers and sisters in Islam, and we take a step back, we realize, subhanAllah, that he is describing values that cannot come to be except through righteous action. That this ummah, the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are an ummah of action, an ummah that was sent to give. And when they give, a system of justice, a system of mercy, a system of wisdom, a system of transformative benefit comes to be and is manifested. This Sharia raises a nation of action. And this theme of action, brothers and sisters in Islam, is manifestly present in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a plethora of places, both in the subtle form and in the direct form. And these examples are many. From them, a surah that is beloved to us and common to our tongues, Suratul Asr, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes an oath by the remnants of time and then says, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ Indeed, all of mankind is drowning in loss, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُ Except those people of Iman.
An iman is not an entity or idea that is separate from action. And thus Allah goes on to mention specific subsets of action. وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. They are people of righteous deeds and action. وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ. And they are people of da'wah. وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. And they are people of patience. Because without patience, you can't have da'wah. And without da'wah, you can't have good deeds. It's da'wah that breeds and brings about a system of good deeds. And without good deeds, then no doubt iman will be affected adversely. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Imran, in terms of the satr, let's complete the satr first. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He tells us about the Anbiya alayhim as-salatu was-salam, such as in Surah Al-Anbiya, in which He mentions their trials and their tribulations, and their efforts and their actions. And then He tells us about His help and assistance that He revealed to them. And He says, إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ. They were a people that hastened to do righteous good deeds. وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَهَبًا. And they were people who worshipped us with hope and with fear. And they were people who submitted with humility. This is who they were. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala subtly introduces us to this idea of action, righteous action, and the fruits of these actions. In Surah Al-Kahf, a surah we read weekly, Allah famously tells us about the story of Musa alayhi salam. And Musa, who was an ocean of knowledge, when Allah taught him that there was another ocean of knowledge, that had a person who had knowledge that Musa alayhi salam didn't have, immediately Musa alayhi salam announces his intent to act. وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِفَتَاهِ. When Musa said to his slave boy, I will not rest until I find him, until I meet him and learn from him, even if it takes me decades. Subhanallah. And throughout his journey with Khidr, when he finally finds him, where the two oceans meet, and subhanallah, it's amazing that the two oceans of knowledge met where the two seas met. Subhanallah. When they met and Musa became a student to Khidr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us throughout the story, فَانْطَلَقَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses this term, انطلاق, a verb or a term from which verbs of action are derived from. And then we also read the story of Dhulqarnayn. And throughout the story, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, فَأَتْبَعَ سَبَبًا ثُمَّ أَتْبَعَ سَبَبًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala highlights His praiseworthy journey as being one connected to action. An action of an obligatory nature, brothers and sisters in Islam, and also a selfless, voluntary nature. Because we are an ummah of action, because we were an ummah that was sent to create value. Not profit, but value, brothers and sisters in Islam. We were an ummah that was sent to live a life. And through living this life, we will teach people how to die in our living, and how to live in our dying. And this is what a legacy is about. That when you leave this earth, the ummah misses you because of the value you created and the value you caused to rise and spread amongst the people and the environment that you live in. This is the subtle description from our sources about the importance of action. We also have direct instructions from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about this, such as in Surah Al-Imran, which I alluded to earlier, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. And rush towards the forgiveness of your Lord. وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ. And a paradise that has a width which is greater than the heavens and the earth. أُعِدَّ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. A paradise that has been prepared for who? The people of taqwa, meaning the people of action. In Surah Al-Hadid, سَابِقُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. Hasten and rush towards the forgiveness of your Lord. Subhanallah. وَجَنَّةٍ. And a paradise, أَرْضُهَا كَعَرْضِ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Subhanallah. A paradise that encompasses the sizes of the heavens and the earth. أُعِدَّ بِالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ. A paradise that Allah prepared for those who believed in Allah and His Messenger. And here we see the term iman used, a term that is not just something specific to the heart, but something that denotes a belief in the heart that is shown through the manifestation of action. This is who we are, O servants of Allah and O children of Adam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding of the great responsibility that sits on our shoulders as members of the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil wahin wa nafa'ani wa iyaakum bihadi sayyidi thaqalain. لقد قلت ما قلت وأستغفر الله العظيم الجليل لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب وخطيئة فاستغفروه إنه كان غفارا وتوبوا إليه إنه كان توابا. الحمد لله على إحسانه وشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه. أحمده سبحانه وتعالى جل جلاله وتقدست أسماؤه فجل عن الشبيه والمثيل والنظير ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. Servants of Allah and our children of Adam, when we tap into this topic of action, then there's many subset topics that exist underneath it. And for the purpose of the remaining time that I have, I'd like to share with you two of these topics. Number one, this action that I refer to, brothers and sisters in Islam, is not an action that we ever retire from. Because this action is connected towards building Jannah. And nobody throughout their life retires from building Jannah when Allah placed you on earth to earn that Jannah and to build it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in his book, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسِ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. There's nothing about you existing except that you were created to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why worship you, Ya Allah? He tells us in Surah Al-Baqarah, Ya أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Worship Allah so that you may attain taqwa. Why attain taqwa, Ya Allah? So that you may enter paradise. For as our scholars have defined at-taqwa, it is a process of building a barrier between you and the hellfire. And when that barrier is built, you only have one point of entry, and that is paradise. And you do this how? Through righteous actions, remaining upon the do's and staying away from the don'ts, looking after the obligatory matters, but not forgetting your responsibility to wider society, the voluntary acts, O servants of Allah and O children of Adam. This is the first point. There's no retirement. As Allah tells us in his book, Infiru khifafan wa thiqala, as he revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions, and it is a message to us. Allah told the young from them and the old to go out in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The last matter, brothers and sisters in Islam, is when we take care of the obligatory matters, we should not suffice with that per se. But rather, we should look after the mandates of the Quran and the Sunnah with all of ourselves. Just like how Allah revealed to Yahya and said, خُذِ الْكِتَابَ بِقُوَّةِ. When Allah revealed to him, he said, oh Yahya, take the book بِقُوَّةِ, in completion, study it, understand it, apply it. This religion is not just about knowledge, brothers and sisters in Islam. And now some scholars argue that knowledge is not knowledge if it's not implemented, it's just mere information. For information is the acquisition of something that needs to be known, but knowledge is applying it, and wisdom is applying it the right way. But when we look in the Quran, O servants of Allah and O children of Adam, we spoke about Allah creating us for Jannah. When He tells us about that Jannah, He says, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, such as in the verse, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ أُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ الْجَنَّةِ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Subhanallah. Allah tells us about those who say they believe and then they walk the talk. It's not just a statement on their tongue, but they manifest through actions what they said on their tongue. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says He will place them in a paradise. Therein they will reside forever. A reward for what they used to do. Not that which they used to talk about. Not that which they used to think about. And that's why we see brothers and sisters in Islam, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'een, they were built upon selflessness, for they were students of the greatest man to walk the face of this earth, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when we look into their action, we see, subhanallah, their connection to the masjid and their efforts towards making the masjid a hub for community development. Thus they selflessly kept themselves there, looking after not just the masjid and its building, but also the causes of the masjid. And we see this in the Medinan model, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam arrives in Medina and he in earnest works towards establishing Masjid al-Nabawi before his own house. And the Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in, they see this from their messenger. So thus they build the masjid with him before taking care of the affairs of the accommodation. SubhanAllah. And then that masjid became the ministry of education, for all education happened from it. The ministry of social affairs, for we know that it housed the people of Ahlul Suffa, those who didn't have a place to stay. They were housed in the masjid. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught them from the students of these people, from this group that were living in the masjid, is the famous Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, many of us don't know, subhanAllah. It was the ministry of defense. They planned how to defend Medina from the attacks of the Quraysh in the masjid. It was the ministry of health. After Uhud, we see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam arriving with the injured at Masjid al-Nabawi and having them treated there. And the list goes so on. And the ministry of information, subhanAllah, for the minbar was the constant place that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would ascend and teach the ummah and address the ummah. This topic is a long one and our time is short. In summary, oh, ummah of action, don't live an exclusive life. Live an inclusive life. As a member of the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it's not just about me, myself and I, you, your family and your bills. It's about a bigger picture. It's about divine values and living upon those values before yaqeen comes, the certainty comes, before the angel of death visits us. Because wallahi wa tallahi wa billahi, my brothers and sisters in Islam, the day we see the angel of death, we will not be thinking about bills and financial standing and material well-being. What we will think about is what we did to represent the legacy of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and how we fared doing so before we passed away. This speech is not in a vacuum. Whenever I visit a community, I speak to the elders of the community or the leaders of a masjid and I ask them, what are the needs of this masjid in light of your vision for the masjid? And the leadership in this masjid have highlighted that one thing that they deeply seek is the community attaching themselves to the masjid. It is the community's masjid. Them attaching themselves and taking ownership of what they can do to make this masjid live its potential. I leave you with this message, my dearest brothers and sisters in Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our past and inspire our futures and make us people of true action. Ameen. Ya Rabbi Alameen. Ibad Allah, inna Allah amarukum bi amrin qad bada'a fihi bi nafsih wa thanna fihi bi malaikatihi al-kiram. فقال تعالى قولا كريما إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما وقد قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى علي صلاة واحدة صلى الله عليه بها عشرة اللهم فصل وسلم وبارك وأنعم على عبدك ورسولك محمد أفضل الخلق وأكرم الرسل وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين الأئمة المهديين الذين قضوا بالحق وبه كانوا يعدلون أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة والتابعين وعنا معهم بمنك وكرمك وإحسانك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أصلح أحوال المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا كلها دقها وجلها سرها وعلانيتها عمدها وخطأها وكل ذلك عندنا ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم عباد الله إن الله يأمركم بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقم الصلاة يرحمكم الله.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله